In this video, we're going to look at what happens when we come across problems that utilize Newton's second law, doing the sum of the forces. But this time around, there are forces acting on an object that are not just acting in the x or y direction at some angle. And to be honest, hopefully by the end of this video, you recognize that while we're going to apply it in a different way, we're kind of doing the same thing that we did when we were learning about projectile motion and other examples of breaking forces or breaking vectors, I should say, into components. So here's what I mean. I'm going to start with an example problem. Okay, we have a person pulling a sled. It says you're pulling a sled as shown, ignoring any friction. No friction on like the ice, no air resistance, nothing like that. Write out Newton's second law for the sled in the x and y direction. All right, there's no numbers. We're just going to write an expression. And I think back to that strategy. We had those numbered items telling us what to do whenever we come across these Newton's second law problems. Let's go ahead and start that strategy. Step one was always to draw a free body diagram. And it's asking about the sled. We're not doing it for the person. We're certainly not doing it for the ice. We're doing it for the sled. So again, I like to write it down just so I'm clear. I'm going to draw my dot. Forces that I know are acting on the sled. Well, I know that the sled is here on Earth, so I'm going to draw a weight force. It's sitting on the ice. The ice must be supporting it, so there's a normal force. There's no friction that we're going to worry about, no air resistance. There is one final force, which is the person tugging on the sled. But notice, the sled is being tugged. The rope is in the direction, some angle theta above the horizontal. If you remember when we talked about tension forces, that force is going to act in that same direction. All right, so normal force acting up, weight acting down, tension at this angle up and to the right. All right, well, the second step was just make sure we know what directions we're going to use. I like doing just up is positive and to the right is positive. Next thing I'm going to do, let's try writing out the sum of the forces in the x and y direction. I'm going to start with the y direction. I'm saying upwards is positive, so I know there's a normal force. There's weight, but weight's acting in the opposite direction. But, uh-oh. This tension force is acting a little bit upwards, right? Well, I can't just put tension here because that wouldn't be accurate. Tension is not acting entirely upwards. It's acting up and to the right. Maybe I'm stuck. Let's try writing out the sum of the forces in the x direction. I'm gonna do that over here. Okay, well, I have tension, and it's kind of acting in the x, but it's not only in the x direction. Okay, and that's the only force, so I better figure out what to write here before I set that equal to the mass times the acceleration. If you have a vector that is not acting in the coordinates you want, remember, you can break vectors down into components. That's the step that you might have to do, especially if you come across problems such as these. If we look back at our list that hopefully you have jotted down, I added a step here. You don't maybe necessarily have to rewrite it. This is what came right after part two before. Maybe you put this as 2B. Okay, don't rewrite the whole thing, but maybe insert this from the list you had before. If you need to, we need to break down any forces into components before we can totally set up Newton's second law. And then we just continue on with our strategy. So I'm gonna break tension into components. I'm gonna redraw the vector. I like to show all my work. Here's tension. I'm gonna use two different colors. Here's gonna be the tension that's acting in the x direction. I'm gonna call that Tx. Here is gonna be the tension that's acting in the y direction. Ty. And this here is theta. Let me flip to white. That's our angle theta. Well, to get an expression for Ty, because I need that, I want to plug something in here. Okay. Well, this is on the opposite side of the angle, and T is the hypotenuse. I know, using my SOHCAHTOA, that this is equal to t multiplied by the sine of theta. If you don't know how to do that, if you haven't just had that like burned into your mind, just do SOHCAHTOA and set up your triangle. But I just, from years of doing this, ty is going to be t sine of theta. Let me flip over to blue. Tx is t cosine of theta. So that's what I'm going to be plugging in my two spots. Because in the x direction, there's only this force here. So it's t cosine of theta equals mass times the acceleration. It doesn't say anything in this problem if it's moving at a constant speed or if it's accelerating, so I'm just going to leave it like this. And then I'm going to plug in, let me flip back to green, plus, because it's acting upwards, t sine of theta. All right? So I broke that force into components, and then I put in those components into the problem. All right? Last thing I would just want to say right here is that, well, you could probably guess that this sled is not launching into the air, right? And it's probably not crashing into the ice, even if it doesn't say it explicitly. This sled, it seems like it's sliding across. You might need to, or you might just be able to infer that if it's not accelerating up or down, the sum of the forces in the y direction should equal to zero. So here's my Newton's second law for the y direction after I broke the forces into components. Here's my Newton's second law in the x direction after I broke that tension into components. Okay, thanks for watching.